So, this is it?
This is it. This is the bathroom.
Wow, it's still hard for me to breathe from up in that attic. Yeah.
This is where it happened?
Yeah. What the tour guide had told me is that there is a ghost in the woman's bathroom, and she's a jealous prostitute. And when girls are washing their hands or doing their makeup, she'll appear behind them and scare them or shove them into walls.
Okay. I do feel there were prostitutes here, but that's not what I'm sensing that you encountered.
Okay.
What happened in this room?
So I was standing here holding the dowsing rods, and this is where I asked the three questions. One was, is there someone in here with me? Cross the rods if it's yes, and it slowly crossed. And then I said, are you female? Cross if yes, and it didn't cross, it stayed forward. And then I said, are you male? Cross if yes. And it flicked back. It was in the room, it was next to me, I could feel it. And then I got spooked. And I just ran out.
You walked out because you got frightened?
It frightened me.
I have to tell you, Audrina, that even though this is the ladies' room, there was a man in here with you. And it was that man. And I just realized his name.
What is
that's what I kept hearing in the car. His name is Charles.
Charles.
But they called him Good Time Charlie.
Good Time Charlie.
I was hearing that in the car. Good Time Charlie, Good Time Charlie. That was his nickname.
Mm-hmm.
Because whenever patrons came here, he had a lot of money. He was a very generous man. He gave people things that they needed. He gave people money as loans.
Mm-hmm.
At the core, I feel Charlie was a good guy.
But then he's so angry.
Mm-hmm. He was in a jealous rage with his wife. She turned heads wherever she went, and Charlie was proud to have her. But Charlie,
he didn't treat her right.
He loved her, but I think he tried to buy her love with lavishing her with really, you know, beautiful things and items and jewelry and furs and all of that. And the only thing he didn't give her is what the bartender did give her. And it was
connection.
Love, compassion, mm-hmm. understanding.
Mm-hmm.
It was Charlie, he felt shame, and I feel like he felt he had so much pride that she chose him over me. That guy?
It was an ego.
Bartender? It's all ego.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. She's telling me the story. He killed her.
Was it in here?
She said, in front of everyone. I hear music playing, everybody's having a good time. The singing, the sounds of men's voices laughing. And then all of a sudden, she's telling me, he shot me in cold blood. I hear the gunshot, and then it's pandemonium. People are running, people are taking cover, they don't know what's going on. And then I just see her laying on the floor, people surrounding her, people running, and it's just a pool of blood coming right out of the side of her head. I feel she's come back today to give him redemption.
To forgive him?
to allow him to free himself. And I'm sorry, Tag, you're it, but you opened the portal for him to tell you his story.
And is it because he just trusted me, or they saw something because I'm the peacemaker, so they thought they could use?
I picked up that energy about you in the car, and I felt that you don't like any disharmony. I felt that if you can give a helping hand, you will. This is no different. He felt your energy.
He thought I could help them move on from this.
I'm really feeling a weight on my chest right now, like I can't breathe.
Yes, 100%. This is where it happened. So I always sleep on this side of the bed.
Here?
I'm sleeping. It's about 2 o'clock in the morning, 2-ish, 2:15, somewhere around there. And I wake up and I feel something on top of me. He's pushing down like this, and I can't move, and I can't scream, and I'm paralyzed. I can't move my head because he's like choking me, and he's compressing my chest.
How do you know it's a he? I just want to...
Okay, there was no way this was a female energy. It was heavy, it was big, it was large, and he's pressing down on me. I'm wondering, what is this? I can't see anything. The room is pitch dark. I am terrified. I mean, like, I can't even tell you the horror that went through my mind. I'm gonna die. I kept thinking, I'm gonna get killed and be dragged down the stairs, never to be heard again. I literally thought, you know, this was demonic. I look up and he's gone. I can now move.
Did you hear breathing in your ear?
Yes, I heard it breathing.
I smell alcohol. Did you smell it that night?
Like, yes, I smelled a little bit of alcohol on his breath, and he smelled like he hadn't taken a shower, really dirty.
This is definitely that guy with the boots. Hold on, I see him. This is the same guy from the car. I feel he was like the army. A captain of the army. At one time, people saluted him, they respected him, and he lost his respect. I'm picking his name up as Harry. He lost his ranking. He had a leg wound.
Oh my God.
And he became depressed. Alcoholic, he had absolutely no money because they threw him out. He was discharged. I was seeing that in the car. He just kept pounding down the drinks, and I said that he had no regard for women. You were a thing.
An object. Like, this is what he did to women when he was living.
That's correct.
Yeah.
You were in a weak and a vulnerable state, or even in a depressed state because of relationship issues. He's a bully. He's got bully energy. It's always about him. He definitely is an alcoholic. That was his downfall. They didn't know each other in life. And then he died shortly after her.
Okay.
Same area.
Okay.
Same area. All this tragedy happened on this beach.
Okay.
You know what, Patty? That woman, I feel she was here protecting you from him.
Well, that was the scariest thing that ever happened to me in my life. I mean, I could tell this story 1,000 times and you'd be the only person who'd understand, because most people thought I was crazy.
She said she's the one that kind of tried to get him out of here. I still feel they wrestle with each other, like, you stay over there, I stay over here. I'll call her Natalie, I think that's her name. What I'm sensing is you're the channel. They were coming into your world saying, this woman understands if we show ourselves to them. She will notice us.
Oh my God.
So that's what's hovering around this place. You kind of encouraged her to get him out of here, because you have the same personality. The feeling I'm getting of what she was feeling as she's about to go over is, I need to get out of this pain, this emotional pain. I don't know what happened to the baby, but but she jumped. She jumped to her death.
What?
The impression that's being fed to me is there's nobody to take care of my baby. It's just me.
Right. Where is this place that she's jumping from?
I'll tell you what I'm seeing. It's like overlooking the scenery out here.
There's a bridge right by here.
Okay. I wonder if that's what I drove over coming here. It felt so sick driving
did,
over.
Did it have like
I called it like, an overpass.
Yeah.
It's like overlooking a whole thing. It looked like an overpass over traffic.
Yeah.
I just got a lot of flashes as I just drove over that overpass. A lot of screams, a lot of wailing. I'm just feeling queasy.
The street's called Colorado Street, and there's like a bridge, a big bridge.
Okay. This may be it, because I just see like concrete, and she just, honestly, I saw her jump. I don't know what happened to the child, but she died tragically.
Where? How did she get here in my life? How is she connected with me and
I'm asking.
Or this house.
Okay. What was going on in that time of life? You're prone to this baby blues, postpartum depression. Something happened, like you were away from your husband. I think it's a little more than that though.
Yes, no one was there to listen to me or care. Or, like, I had no friends. I was so, like, I felt like I wasn't me. I felt really like I couldn't look at myself in the mirror. If I did brush my teeth, I would brush them in the dark. But that was so sad and so, like...
Kendra, you wanted to take your life back then? That's how deep I'm getting. That's the feeling I'm getting.
There were a couple moments where I've wanted to take my life.
But especially then, when after the baby?
Yeah, I felt really low at the time.
It's the same feeling, though. I'm trying to bring up a connection and a parallel to this lady.
Sure.
She has regrets. Kendra, she knows you. She remembers you from this place. And I feel like she's a kindred soul. Like, she has a lot in common with you. So she found you. She knows you. She knows what you were going through back then. I feel like she was able to kind of sympathize with you.
Yeah. Huh.
So.
I don't know if I should be scared or just accept it. I don't know, but it just freaks me out. It feels like tight and just claustrophobic and.
Okay, so let's go into the nursery, see what else I can pick up in that room. Let's go.
Okay.
What is it?
I don't know. I just got overwhelmed with emotion right now. Sorry, it's just, I have postpartum blues from my daughter.
But is it good emotion, bad emotion?
Like, it just hit me. Even though it was scary in here. It was just me and little Hank for a while, and his first place he walked was here. I miss him as a baby.
And this brought back the memories for you, right? That was your first baby. That was your buddy.
Yeah, I just got overwhelmed
when
the store opened.
I know.
I think I miss him so much. And I just remember the bookshelves right here, and we had his toys all over here, and it just hit me with so much emotion.
But is it because you feel like you didn't really enjoy the moments? Is that what you're telling me?
No, I just missed the moments. I feel like this was maybe the only place where I felt like we had this a bond. I was very busy before this, traveling and packing and shooting my show, and after I did Dancing with the Stars, I was so like busy, and I feel like in this industry you only have one shot. If you don't take these chances and you're too picky with them, then you're gonna lose your shot.
You know, so this was the only time that you were that mom that you wanna be.
Yes. even though it was so scary in here, I still felt like I protected him, like.
It was you and him against the world.
I guess that's why I never slept. I just wanted every moment. I wanted every moment with him, like.
How old is your new baby?
She's 6 months.
Grandpa came through and he says, maybe coming back here today, showing you, you don't want to have that happen all over again with your daughter because you can't get those moments back.
Yeah.
Think about that. I want to weigh in with what I'm being shown because to hear the agony that you're going through and it's internal struggles, internal emotional issues that really haunted you then and they're still haunting you now. I kind of feel this other desperate woman that jumped was in a very, very similar situation to you. Whether you know this or not, you've also been battling depression your whole life.
Right, I have, right.
Can I ask you a question?
Go ahead.
Why did you think those orbs were about to harm your child?
It wasn't natural, and I'd never experienced something like that.
That's a fair answer, very, very fair. Especially not knowing any better. Can I kind of just reverse this for you a little bit?
Sure.
And make you realize that you always expect the negative. This woman wasn't out to harm your child. She was really watching over Hank Jr. And maybe because you were at your lowest point, she wanted to make sure you were not a threat to yourself or to the baby. Do you realize, Kendra, that your whole life you've been in survival mode? You have been in survival mode.
I have been.
Fight or flight.
Yes.
You haven't enjoyed the moments.
There's a bullseye and you had a dart, you just hit the bullseye right there.
There's people in your life that love you so much and then they're needing you. They're needing your love, your attention.
Mm-hmm.
This woman has been with you as the protector. Maybe she saw the signs in you that she had. That's usually what happens. That's what I'm picking up. I want to see if there's a draw from someplace else.
The backyard always used to spook me for some reason. I mean, it's always been like that. There's something about it. Never went out there.
I know you don't like to, but I think we need to.
It's a little spooky out here. I haven't been out here in
many years. Take the lights and...
I don't know, there was always something unsettling about back here.
Because there's something beyond these trees.
It was always this quiet.
I think that might be key. I think it's a different house right beyond these trees that she would go to open the home of the man, her lover.
Right.
And she, hold on a second. She came in the house, she started a fire. She was setting the stage to make a nice night.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like she wants to make up for arguing. A spark of the fire jumped out onto the shag rug. She's running, frantic, panic-stricken. I see her taking a blanket and throwing, worst thing she could have done.
Mm-hmm.
I see the whole house engulfed in flames around the whole perimeter. She kept trying to put this fire out. I feel like I'm choking and I'm... She died before the fire. She died...
smoke inhalation?
That's how she died.
The man came home that night to a horrible scene. I don't know, it was something she always wore. It's what he gave her, it's a necklace. And they brought it out. And he knew she never took that off. He knew she was in there. He truly loved her. All I could see is him going on to his knees, sobbing, sobbing, sobbing. But it was too late.
Yeah.
And
I always thought she was there to give me a message.
Did she come to tell me something that was going to happen or that maybe I could figure out a way to stop it from happening?
As much as I thought about why she was in the house, what her story was, it was a very important piece of my life.
You think you might have been able to prevent it in some way, or you feel responsible?
Right.
Then the point is, you couldn't do anything. Catherine came to you for another purpose.
Oh, I see.
Hold on a second.
She's still here?
Oh, she's here, all right. She told me she admires you for your tenacity, your strength, your bravery.
Mm-hmm.
You were what she always wanted to be. She was seeking this man's love to validate who she is. And you were never this person who needed to be validated by the outside world.
No, I don't get my self-esteem. I don't find my self-esteem in that way.
Exactly. This woman did.
Right.
It's a woman who wanted to know your secret. You were really serving as someone who can inspire her.
Yeah. Well, maybe she's come to me for advice.
Exactly.